Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to download and install Python and how to set it up for Visual Studio Code. So let's get started. So just go to Google and type download Python. You'll be getting the first link for python.org's download. Just click on download Python, and in this you'll be having the download option, and here also you're having download Python 3.11.4, which is the latest version. Just click on that and your download will be getting automatically started. It is just about 24 MB in size, so pretty fast download. So once the download is completed, just click on open and you'll be getting the install Python setup. And in this you need to like make sure that you are checking this particular option, okay? Add python.exe to path. Be careful there, and I'll just go with the default path and I'll just click on install now. I'll just click yes. So it will take some time for the Python setup to install. So once we are done installing, we will be getting setup was successful. Just click on close. Now we are done. So next thing, we need to check if we have successfully installed Python. So for doing that, just go to search and open your command prompt. I'll just zoom it to the max and I'll just type python hyphen hyphen version. So here you can see that I'm getting the latest version, that the version that we just saw earlier. So after doing this, if you want to like run some code immediately, what you can do is just go to search and you can search for idle. So you'll be getting this idle Python app. Just click on open and you'll be getting the Python shell in case if you want to run some commands like print, let me say 1, 2, 3. You can just run and check any Python commands that you want. And in case if you want to like run a full program, you can just click on file, new file, and you'll be getting a file opened. So let me just now save it first. So I'll just say Python trial program maybe. I'll just click on save and I'll just run just a print. That's it, print hello world, the famous hello world program, and run it. So I'll be getting the output. So this is a place where you can run standard Python programs. And in case if you aren't getting the version when you type Python hyphen hyphen version, just go to search and type edit the system environment variables. Just go for environment variables, and in this you'll be having the path. Okay, so this is the path under user variables. You'll be having the path. Just click on edit and make sure that you have these two paths added: local programs Python scripts and local programs Python. So in case if it is not working, all right. So just go to Google and type download Visual Studio Code. You will be getting the first link over here as codevisualstudio.com. Just click that. And here you will be having Visual Studio Code for different OS. There is for Windows, Linux and Mac. I'm going to download it for Windows. So I'll just click on this Windows, okay? So download will get automatically started. So it is about 88.8 MB in size. So just be patient. So once the download is complete, just click on open. And you'll be getting like this license agreement. Just click on I accept. You can just scroll down and read it. Next. So this is the location where Visual Studio Code will be installed. So if you want, you can just browse and change the location. I am fine with the default one. Just click on next and next as well. And here you can like create a desktop icon, and it's always good to have this one. Just check this. Okay. Action to Windows Explorer. Yeah. Better to give check everything and just click on next and install. Such a simple installation process. Okay. Yeah. So once the installation is done, just click on launch Visual Studio Code and click on finish. So this is the first interface that you will be getting after you launch Visual Studio Code. So you can like change the theme, and in this what you are doing is, let me just now expand it a bit. Yeah, you need to go to file and open folder, and you need to go to your desired folder. Okay, so let me just go to desktop and we just create new folder. I will name it as Python project something. You can just name it anything, and I will just select that folder and click select folder, and I will just click yes, I trust the authors. And so here you can see, right, my folder has been opened now, but inside that I'm not having any contents. So you need to click on this new file, and if you want another folder inside this, you need to click on new folder. I will just click on this file and I will just type first program something like that. And after that you need to type the .py extension. So it's going to be .py, which refers this to a Python file, and just hit enter. So after that, we will be like able to see our file. This is basically empty now, and you'll be getting a pop-up warning like this. Do you want to install the recommended Python extension? Just click on install. So this is that particular Python extension. It is from Microsoft. This will basically help you in autocomplete and IntelliSense. So it's always better to have some extensions. So now we are done. And in case if you aren't getting any recommendations like that, what you need to do is you need to click on this extension. Okay. Click on this extension and you need to search for Python over here. And I think this is the first one you'll be getting. See the number of downloads. It's the most famous Python extension, I guess. So that's it. Once we are done adding this extension, we need to just reload or restart our VS Code so that the extension's functions are getting affected. So just close and open Visual Studio Code. Yeah, I've just now closed and opened my Visual Studio Code. And if you're having your font size very small, you need to click on this manage like settings like icon, and you need to go to settings, and here you'll be having the font. So I'll just like reduce it. Mine is too large. I'll go with 40, and it will be like directly affected. So this is the way to change the font size. And now let me type some basic Python. Print the famous hello world. Yeah. And you need to save it. Control S. And after that, you'll be getting a run icon like this. And you'll be getting this run icon only after installing that particular Python extension. And don't forget to reload your Visual Studio Code also. Just click on this run. And in the terminal, so here you can see we will be getting hello world in the output. So that's it. Basically, this is how we set up Python in VS Code. And I hope you would have found this video useful, guys. Do check the playlist of my channel. I've done many programming tutorials in Python, C, C++, Java, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB, MySQL, Spring Boot, CRUD operations, as well as Figma and 3D animations using Blender. Check them out. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.